We have very tall ceilings in our house, which means very large walls and typically very large and expensive wall art. I wanted some unique artwork for this big blank wall in our living room, so I decided to make this giant mosaic mirror. It's huge. It's almost 4 feet wide and 5 feet tall, and it only cost me around $100 to make. Let's go see how I did it.
This video is sponsored by Cricut. I started the project by purchasing 200 4-inch square mirrors. These are the type of mirrors that are often used in a centerpiece or maybe for wedding decoration, so they're pretty inexpensive. Each pack of 50 costs less than $20. To give the mirror a mosaic look and to create kind of a feeling of texture, I decided I was going to create multiple geometric patterns using adhesive vinyl. I chose multiple different colors and finishes, including a frosted glass look and a glossy beige vinyl. I knew there was no way I'd be able to create the intricate geometric patterns I wanted by hand, so I decided to try out my brand new power tool. I'm talking about my Explore 3 electronic cutting machine by Cricut. I know it may be weird to think of a machine typically sold at the craft store as a power tool, but for a maker like me, that's what it is. The Cricut Explore 3 is a smart cutting machine that can cut, emboss, perforate over 100 different materials. You're definitely not limited to only cutting things like vinyl and paper. If you need to cut thicker materials like leather or even wood veneer, Cricut makes a machine that can handle those materials as well. It's called the Maker 3. The Explore 3 has the ability to draw really complex images like logos or customized branding. Cricut cutting machines work with a program called Cricut Design Space, which was surprisingly easy to learn. I use the desktop version, but they have a mobile app as well if that's more your speed. Design Space allows you to design your own project and add as much detail as you want. The tools are pretty intuitive, even if you don't have a lot of experience in graphic design. You also have the option to upload and modify an existing image, or download and use a fully developed project file. I created 4 different patterns for my mosaic mirror, and each only took a few minutes to design. Something really cool that I discovered about the Explore 3 is its ability to use what's called smart vinyl. Cricut now makes a whole line of smart products, which can be rolled out and used directly into the machine. They don't require the additional step of cutting the material down and attaching it to a cutting mat. However, a cutting mat is still available to use and really opens up the options for the materials that you're going to incorporate into your project. I cut out 4 to 8 copies of each pattern from my different materials. I try to get a good variety of textures and colors. For complex and delicate patterns, I used what's called transfer tape. Transfer tape is basically a clear adhesive film that I secure to the front side of my vinyl. I was then able to remove the parts of the pattern that I didn't want to transfer, that's called weeding, and align the pattern vinyl on top of my mirror. I applied my vinyl designs to over 70 different mirror tiles. I'll be honest, this was definitely the most time-consuming part of this project, but it was kind of relaxing to just sit down and get some work done. Also, seeing each design and color come to life on the mirror was kind of fun. Now that my geometric designs were attached and my mirrors were ready to go, I needed something to mount the mirrors on. I had a piece of leftover 3/4 inch thick MDF left over from an upcoming project. Although MDF is pretty heavy, it was actually great for this project because it doesn't tend to warp or flex like plywood can. I cut the MDF down to size about 44 inches wide and 68 inches tall and hand sanded the edges to get it ready for paint. I applied 2 coats of shellac-based primer and 2 coats of silver spray paint to the edges of my MDF panel. As the paint dried, I turned my attention to cutting down 20 packs of wooden shims. The idea was to use the shims behind a random number of mirrors, creating an offset and kind of faceted look. I found the easiest way to cut down the hundreds of shims that I needed was to tightly wrap the packs in painter's tape before trimming them down on the miter saw. I cut the shims down to 3.5 inches in length, making sure they'd be able to hide behind the 4-inch wide mirrors. Once the MDF panel was dry, I began laying out the pattern for the mirrors using the mirrors themselves. I then used a straight edge to connect the lines that I had made using the mirror template. I connected my lines going the opposite direction and was left with a grid with 187 squares. Before I could apply the mirrors, I needed to first attach my shims to my MDF panel. I applied a healthy amount of wood glue to the back of the shims and attached them in pairs to the grid. I alternated the direction that the shims were angled and tried to space them randomly. Some of the squares in the grid were left blank. I let the glue for the shims dry overnight, and then it was time to start attaching my mirror tiles. I used a construction adhesive that's specifically designed to use on mirrors. It has a high tack, which grabs the mirrors right away, preventing them from slipping around while I'm making adjustments, and the formula won't damage the mirror's delicate silver backing. I found it easiest to lay out my design if I worked in rows. I began by first applying the mirrors with no shim behind them, and then followed up by attaching the angled shim mirrors. Believe it or not, it only took me a couple of hours to apply all 187 mirror tiles. Liking what you see? Tag that like button down below. And if you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe as well. Once the construction adhesive was fully cured, it was time to think about how I was going to mount my giant mosaic mirror to the wall.
This bad boy is pretty heavy, so I want a really secure way to mount it onto the wall. I'm using what is called a French cleat. It's basically two interlocking brackets that go together. They've been around forever. You can actually make them yourself. I really like how slim and low profile the aluminum ones are that you can buy from the hardware store. I think this one is rated up to like 200 pounds. So right now I need to attach this piece to the back side of the mirror. And then this one will go inside and mount it to the wall.
I attached the French cleat to the MDF panel using 1/2-inch screws. One of the nice things about the particular French cleat that I used is it comes with a built-in level bubble. I selected a cleat that was 30 inches long. We were able to locate two different studs on the wall and attach the wall bracket using the included finish nails. Are you ready to see how my giant mosaic mirror turned out? I'll be honest, I was a little worried about how this project was gonna look. But now that I've seen it up on the wall, I absolutely love this mirror. Photos really don't do it justice. Because I was able to pick out the colors and designs myself, it blends seamlessly with the rest of the decor in our house. That's the beauty of DIY artwork. It's worth investing the time not only to save some money, but to get the best look. If you want to learn more about the DIY modern house we just built, make sure you check out the full Building Modern on a Budget video series. And if you like other types of DIY, check out this video as well. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys think about more home decor related content. And as always, thanks for watching, guys.